Okay, so welcome back. Now we have to deal with the faces of this particular column. Now this will be a bit complicated, okay, because you really need to focus. Because the end here, I need to regeneralize it because I can change, I would like to change the end at my gaze. It's a circle, okay? When it's a circle, the lesser point you have, the less it resembles a circle, okay? So we must have the exact number of points so that it can actually look like a real circle. So we have to generalize it. So look at this figure here. These are the different faces that I would like to program there. You see that there's an intimate link between the number of nodes, okay, and the number of faces. Look at here, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 nodes. Okay, that's 8 vertices, right? How many faces am I having? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Are you seeing that? So you see that the number of faces here, the number of rectangular faces is equal to the number of nodes. Okay, so that's why I'll use a for loop where at each iteration I will make sure that I complete a particular face. Okay, so I'll have to create these faces not as rectangles but as triangles. Triangles have 3 nodes per element. Okay, why do I want to do it as triangles? Because our cylinder is supposed to be closed. It is a closed column. Okay, it's not supposed to be open. Okay, that would be to show that our material is compact somehow. It is closed in the inside. So this is the way I will close it. Hope we are still together. It means this node, for this element, this node and this node, I will link it to the center. For this element, this node and this node, I will link it to the center. So these triangles like that will be formed in order to close the top and down of the cylinder. Okay, so for a particular iteration I'll create this face and then the closure of this face and the closure down of this very face. All of them will be triangles. Okay, so for illustration, what shall we do? We'll say I going from 1 to n. Okay, going from 1 to n. Good. And so what we don't have in this particular vertices is the coordinate of the center, okay? But we know our center. Our center is at 0, 0, 0, okay? And here, if we're putting it here, it means that we're putting it as the very last coordinate. Keep that in mind. It's very important. Okay. So we'll say for I equals to this. So very first thing, I'll create fact is equal to zeros of let me ask a question. How many elements will I have at the end of the day? Normally for one iteration like this one, I'm supposed to have let me check something now, please. Good. So for one iteration like that, I'm supposed to have this rectangle will divide itself into 2 triangles. Okay, so I'll have a triangle from here to here. Let me just try and draw something. Come on, don't waste my time. Oh. So from here to here, I'll have a triangle, okay? And then I'll have another triangle that will close this particular face. So I'll have a triangle from here to the center. Where is that center? To the center, and then to here, that's another triangle, okay? And then the last triangle will be from here to the center. Oh, where is the center here? No, that's not the center. Anyway, that's sorry, that's not the center. Oh, let's do control Z, okay? Oh, let's delete this. So it will be from here to the center, which is somewhere here to here. Okay, that's the other triangle. So I'll have 1, 2, 3 and 4 triangles for one element. Now, if I'm saying that I will go n around, okay, it means it will be 4 times n elements that I will have, okay? So the number of lines will be 4 times n elements. And then the number of columns obviously will be xyz. It's not xyz. It will be 3 nod per element, 3 vertices per element, okay? Good. So that's what I'll have. So the I here, listen, the I here represents my initial number. That is, I'm going from 1 right up to 8. Okay? That's what the I here represents. It represents my initial number. So I initially is 1. Okay? So what does it mean? I'll have a first element. What I'll have, I'll create a number here, C, which I'll call, which is equals to 1, okay? That C is supposed to indicate to me the position where I'm found on my, on indexing my fact, okay? So I will say face of C, comma, that is all the C-th line, which will be 3 elements, obviously, will have to be equal to, so what will be the first element here? I can say the first element is 1, 2, 10, right? So look at what is the link between 2 and 10. You see that the link between 2 and 10 is that they have a difference of 8. And coincidentally, 8 is our number, is our number n. Are you seeing that? The same as the difference between 1 and 9, they have a difference of 8. And 8 is still n. So the difference between the numbers that are down and the numbers that are up are always 8. That is 2 and 10 is 8. 3, their corresponding numbers up, sorry. 3 and 11 is 8, 4 and 12 is 8, 5 and 13 is 8. That's the difference, okay? So it means when I have, for example, I here, my I here represents this one, okay? Then what would this number be? It would be I plus 1, right? Because the difference between 1 and 2 is 1. So I'll have I plus 1, okay? That's the next node. And then the triangle up here, what will it be? It will be I plus 1, this one, plus 8, okay, which gives me I plus 1 plus n, okay? I say I'm putting it n, not 8, because I can change any at any time, but the same thing will go for any n given, okay? So this will be my first triangle, this triangle here. So you see that when it goes to the next, when it goes to I equals to 2, now it will be 2, 3, and 11. So it will be this triangle here, okay? But we are still at 1. So that will be for it. When I'm done with that, I will say C is equal to C plus 1, so that I can go to the second line now, okay? I can be on the second line now. Now here, C is equal to 2. That's my second line. Good. So now for this other triangle, what will it be? It will be I and then 9, right? I is 9 is what? Is the 1 plus 8. So it will be I, that is 1, then I plus 8, which is n. Okay? Then this one again, I, 10 again is I plus 1 plus n. Correct. Okay? So we are through with that. C is equal to C plus 1. Okay, so now we are dealing with the other triangles that close this particular element. Okay. So now C is 3. What will it be? For the one down here, I will have I plus 1. So I plus 1. Good. Then I'll have the coordinate of the center. The coordinate of the center, where is it stored? It is stored at the end of my vert. Okay, so I can say vert. If it's stored at the end, what would I say? I'll say size of vert, comma, what? The number of lines, right? 1. So you see that the number of lines of vert will give me the number of vertices that are there, the number of coordinates that are there, the number of nodes that are there. And we are saying that this coordinate here is the last node. Okay, so it means that the number of nodes will correspond to the number of the last nodes. Okay, so we can use this confidentially, no problem, it will always work. Good. Oh, but we'll have a problem at this level here. Okay, we will have a problem, so we need to save another thing here. Okay, this one will be the center for the circle that is down, okay? This will be the center for the circle that is down. We need another center for the circle that is up. Okay? And that circle will be at a distance of Z following, okay? Of L rather, following Z up here. Okay? So it means that here will be size of vert minus 1. That will be the center for this. And then, again, the same thing. Okay, but this time around, you'll be what? I plus N, and I plus 1 plus N. That will be the two beginnings. Okay, and their center will be vert. So, we should not forget to say C has to be equal to C plus 1. So, this will work, okay? It will give us all the faces right up to the last but one face, which is this particular one here. Because here, if I say 8 and I say 8 plus 1, 8 plus 1 is not 1, okay? Here, 7 plus... Ooh, I had not thought of that. Why did I not think of that? Wow. It is now that I'm actually thinking of something very, very special. So, listen, we must not even, oh my God. So, what we'll do is that we'll just do all of this, we'll do mod, okay, modulus of all of this, comma, what will it be, comma what, all along, comma 8, no, it will not work, okay, it will not work, let's just go straight to read things. It will work, but let's simplify. So it means that this will work in the case where, that is, if I, okay, is less than or different from n, okay, where is this, if I is different from n, then this will work. In the last case where I is equals to n, we have a different scenario there altogether. Okay. We have a different scenario. So here we'll have else. So before the end of this video, just to prove that we are not, okay, wasting time here, we'll say here column, okay, and we'll change the length element back to 1, and let's see what that gives us. Oh, I don't like that noise. I don't like it. What have we done wrong this time around? What is it telling us? That horizontal concatenation was not possible. How come? So what's the time left in this video? Oh, so we'll continue from here in the next video, okay? Thank you very much.